Hi guys, just a quick video. I wish I had the camera rolling earlier because that would have been epic, but yeah, as you can see, if you're wondering what this is the one of the kettle leads I've been using when I've been tinkering with the desktops on the Lego shelf over there. And I'd plug this into the Dell up there, and nothing worked. It was dead. So I thought, it might be the power supply. So I went and grabbed another power supply, connected that to the motherboard, just to, you know, intending to test it, and I heard a few sparks when I plugged it in. Thought it actually came from the power supply itself. And it stopped, so I just left it. Pressed the button in front of the computer, and, well, yeah, that started spitting flames and sparks and smoking from that area. From the live wire as well. So, after I quickly turned the power off and yanked the plug, whew, still stinks in here though. Yeah, it's good that I don't panic, really, isn't it? Yeah, that cable's going into the bin. But I tried the cable from the monitor. Turns on fine. There's nothing wrong with the existing power supply. And I plugged it into that. No sparks. I got sparks from that before I'd even turned the computer itself on. So, I now need to find an extra power lead, but yeah. I have no idea how it happened. I don't know if there's a short in there somewhere, or a short in the plug, maybe. What I think is actually the, yeah, the live one in there isn't as shiny as the neutral on Earth. I'm surprised it didn't blow the fuse or, trip the, circuit breaker, to be honest. It didn't do anything like that. Well, it just goes to prove that you can't always rely on the fuse in the plug. So, yeah, that was just a little interesting, escapade. At least I didn't have to call the farmer now. Oh dear. It's one for the bin. It's another one on the list I've got to find. I haven't got a bin bag in the bin, I should say, so I'll just throw it down there for now. Anyway. I think that's probably one of the most interesting electrical things that's ever happened to me. I just wish I had the camera going at the time. I really did, but you know, I couldn't really just let it burn while I grab a camera, could I? So I had to extinguish it. You know, I'm not going to burn me flat down for the sake of a YouTube video. So, sorry about that, but it was definitely interesting. Can't deny that. That was definitely an interesting experience. It's the first time I've had a cable do that. So, yeah. Maybe next time I can capture something like that on video. But until such time, I'll talk to you again soon. Bye.